Assalamu alaikum friends, my name is Muhammad Yunus and I am Udo technical developer. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click the subscribe button and also click the bell icon to get the updates of the upcoming videos. In today's video, I am going to discuss how to customize the Udo QA PDF report header and footer. So we will change this header to this one. Okay, and it will take effect on all the reports because we are going to change the PDF report header of Udo default. So if we go to settings and then journal settings, and then here under the document layout, we can see that we can change the layout of the PDF report. So let me just click on the configure layout, and then we will see the different type of styles are available to choose. So it depends on your company, like which style they want to use and which layout they want to use. They can add the colors and all these details. But if you don't, like if you want to change the header and footer for any of these style, you can just choose it and then save it. Okay. So once you save it, then you will have the layout ID here, and then you can click on the edit layout. So this is the XML code for this header and footer and this whole styles, and we can find this layout, this XML code in the web module, and this is the external ID of that specific record. So if we want to find this in the Udo default add-ons, we need to go to the add-ons, and then we need to search for web module, and let me search it. So inside the web module, we need to search for this specific XML ID, which is external layout standard. So this is the ID which we are looking for. So let me just open it, and here is the code for this layout. And this, like here is the header section, which starts from here and then ends here. This is the body section, which is the report data. And this is the footer section, which you can say like the class is footer. So in this video, we are just going to replace this code with our custom header, and so that we can bring the like the logo in the center and the company details on the left side. So for this purpose, we need to create a new XML file in our custom module which we are working, which is Open Academy. So let me just close this folder, and here I will create a new file with the name, let me just say custom header.xml, like this. And then inside it, I will need to add the Udo tag and then encoding like this, and then I need to inherit this template which we already open here like this. So in order to do so, we just need to copy it like this and then close the tag. So as this is the Udo like the header external ID, we need to add here inherit ID. So we want to inherit this one, and we need to add the module name where it is defined. So as we know, this is defined inside the web module, and we can find it from here, like this is inside the web module. And then we need to define a unique ID for this layout in our custom module, which will be like ID equal to, so we can say external layout standard. We can say Open Academy, yes, Open Academy, like this. So this is like just we have inherited the template. The next step here is to define like which part we want to replace. So in this case, we want to replace the first div because it is responsible for the header. So in order to do so, we need to add the XPath, which is XPath EXPR, which is the expression. So here we need to define div. So there are two ways, like we can define, if we want to only replace the first div, we can just add it like this without adding the course, and then we can just add position equal to replace like this, and it will replace the div with number first. But if you want to specify the number for the div that which we want to replace, it is also okay, but it is used mostly in case if you want to like replace the second div or third div, you can give the specific number. So here let me just paste the code which I have already added for the report. So here it is. So this is the code. I don't want to explain this in much detail because this is the code that is written simply in XML. I just added the report for the updated header, which is like on the left side, the company detail, and then the company logo in the center, and then the print detail on the right side. So this is it. And then we need to add this XML file in the manifest file. So after adding in the manifest file, we will just need to upgrade the module. So it is inside the reports folder, and then we know that this XML header is defined in the web module. So we need to add the web module inside the dependency of our custom module. So this is really important, like this. So, and then we need to just start Odoo service because we have made changes inside the XML and also the Python code, and then we need to upgrade the module. So in order to upgrade the module, just click the upgrade button to upgrade it. So the module has been upgraded, and let me go to the courses and then print the course. So after printing, we will see that the header is updated. So we got the new reports, and here it is. So the header is now the updated one which we have added, but keep in mind that this will update the report of the header of all the reports. So for example, if you go here and if you try to print the report for the sales order, you will get the updated header. So in order to just make like modify the header of a specific report, I will just make another video on this topic because the video will become very lengthy. So this is, you can say it has been updated like this. Okay, so another thing you need to keep in mind, that is like if we go to the settings, and if I update the layout to another one, like for example, so we got an error message. So let me say, what is this? Okay, so there is a problem in the XML that we have written. So let me update it. So after some research, I found that context timestamp was causing the problem. So I removed it, and it's working fine now. So if I change the layout, for example, if I go here, if I make it boxed and save it, let me print the report again. Let me check it. So here you say that it changes the header like to the one that is provided by Odoo, this external layout boxed. Okay, this is because we have just inherited the custom the standard layout, like in this case the light one, but there are total four layouts. So if you want to change it for everyone, so you just need to inherit every of the layout, for example this layout, and then you need to just copy this. So the same way you have done this one, you can just like duplicate this code like this, and then put it here. The you just need to put the external ID here like this one, and then we need to copy it from here and make it like this so that it is unique. So, and then just need to upgrade the module to see the change. So if you update the module, so this report, this layout will also get updated, and it will just show us our custom header. But keep in mind that this will affect all reports that are developed in Odoo. But if you want to make it for a certain report in like for this course report, we can just edit, and I will explain it in the next video. Okay, so let me check the report. So here you can see that it has been updated to the one that we have customized. So we have just inherited two of these header XML templates, but if you want, you can just do the rest of them the same way I have done, and it is really easy. If you have any question, you can join our Discord group. The link of the Discord group is in the description of the video. And if you enjoyed this video, please give a huge thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so that you can get the updates of the upcoming videos. Thank you.